Hey everyone, welcome back to my channel. Today I want to talk to you about the infamous dark front tooth. Tooth that everybody kind of looks at, you notice it. A lot of us are having pictures and more, and we're all self-conscious about that front dark front tooth, but we really don't know our options, and a lot of dentists really don't give a lot of options or explain it well. I'm here to share with you today how we're going to fix it and how it's easily fixed, both from a time perspective and also from an expense standpoint. So if you want to hear more about that, then let's get started. We are all being photographed, videoed, all kinds of ways, even if we're not really that type of person that takes selfies. We see ourselves in pictures more and more. But one of the things that really stands out in a photograph, from even from a distance, is a dark front tooth. And a dark front tooth will typically be caused by a tooth that has had some sort of trauma. It may have had infection, but usually it's a trauma, and the nerve inside the tooth will die, and that the breakdown products are sort of like the, you think about a leaf when it's, you know, after it's fallen, it turns brown. Teeth are very similar. So once something's fallen off the regular blood supply of the rest of the mouth, then it starts to turn dark. And this dark material that's now inside, in the chamber inside the tooth, can actually leach out into little tubules inside the tooth and actually come to the surface and make the tooth, which is normally a very translucent type thing, now reflect light and make it look dark. So it always pops in a photo, and it's really hard to hide unless it is your lower front tooth. But if it's your upper front tooth, it's particularly problematic. And I see time and time again people who'll tell me, you know, oh yeah, I had a root canal in that tooth, or I had a bump in that tooth. Is there anything you can do? And so I get that question a lot, and I thought today I would share with you what you can easily and simply do, or what I can do as a dentist to fix that. And again, just how easy it is. It's so crazy. We have great materials now that we can do it and give you options to solve that problem. So I want to sort of take you through that, okay? So the first thing we're going to do as a dentist is we're going to take an x-ray. So when I look at the tooth, an x-ray of a tooth like that will tell me one of two things. It's either had a root canal and there's this material inside the tooth, and it'll show up like bright white in the x-ray, and that's called gutta percha, and that's when it's a slam dunk. Another type of case will happen is the tooth has not had a root canal, it had a trauma, but now the nerve chamber where the nerve was is actually obliterated. It's gone. The whole tooth looks like a solid material color, one color. And that's partly because as the tooth was dying, the materials sort of built up like a defense mechanism and sort of like closed itself off. So slowly but surely, in a natural way, the tooth lost the blood supply. And it as well will also look dark. So those are the two main things that I see. Rarely though, I'll see the tooth is dark and the tooth's never had a root canal and the canal chamber's still there. Now that means I can easily do a root canal and put that gutta percha material in. And so that now brings me to my next stage. So if I see you with that in there, and like I said, that's the reason why I say that's a slam dunk, is because I'm going to make a little hole in the back of the tooth, and I'm going to open it up just big enough to place a special gel inside the tooth. When I do that, I'm going to clean the inside of the tooth. We have different solutions and things like that to basically disinfect and sort of wash out any remnants of, you know, dark material, but we can only do so much. A lot of times the stain has gone right through the tubules and made its way to the surface, and that is something then that can only be reversed in one of two ways. I can either place a gel inside the tooth, which will then, over a period of probably up to a week, I have seen an improvement in as little as 12 hours. That gel is like a bleach material. It's a peroxide based gel, and it will actually like sort of clean or whiten, brighten the inside of the tooth. So the tooth gets brightened from the inside out. I put it in with a little cotton pellet, and then when I take it out the next week, the tooth's already whiter. Sometimes I'll reapply it, but that rarely happens. I find the gel that we use now is so good that we usually have to do one application of that. So I'll put a temporary plug over the back of the tooth, set you on your way, and then when you come back, your tooth's whiter, and we will replace that with a new filling material, like a total filling material. If you haven't had a root canal already, we'll have to do the root canal first, then place the whitening material inside or the gel in the cotton pellet and do it the same way. But the third thing is if it has just obliterated. So if the nerve chamber is completely like kind of closed itself off and it hasn't, there's no easy way to do a root canal. I don't want to be invasive to your tooth for no good, you know, not no good reason, but I don't want to be invasive to your tooth and make it very difficult. So there's always the option we can ask a specialist to look at that, because sometimes they have special tools that they can access that tooth. But generally, I have worked with endodontists in the past, and what's typically said is, look, there's no infection here. The nerve's just died. It's not going to be an easy way to kind of get in there to place this material. So what we'll typically do then is we may have to more focus on external whitening solutions. And my sister actually is a prime example of this. She fell over her bike. She was riding home from the beach one day, and she had a little plastic bag for her towel. It got caught up in the wheel. She went over the handlebars, darkened her front tooth. And so when I sent her to the endodontist, he said, look, it's not easy to do a root canal, but let's try external whitening. So we'll always selectively try external whitening if we can't do the whitening from the inside out. Once the whitening has occurred or the gel has done its job, we will then, like I said, put a filling material in the back of the tooth, and then we're gonna look at the big picture again. Do any of the other teeth, the whole smile, does it need to be whitened? Is there any external whitening that we need to do? The way we make bleach trays here in this clinic is we'll do a digital scan of your mouth, and we will create a digital model, we'll print it, and then we have like a little suck down tray that we make, and that allows us to keep the gel sitting against all the outer surfaces of the teeth overnight. As the days go by, of course, the whole smile gets whiter and whiter. But if you had one dark tooth, what I will do is suggest, we had a patient the other day, she had one dark tooth and then the canines were a bit dark. So I said, look, just put the gel in the tray where the dark teeth are first. Get those kind of bumped up to the level of the other teeth. Then you can go in and you can, you know, apply the whitening gel to all the external surfaces of the rest of the teeth. And so that kind of gets everything on an even playing field. And so similarly with just the single dark tooth, I may do the internal whitening, but if I didn't do the internal whitening, I'll get, as I did my sister in my sister's case, get to just do selective whitening on that one dark tooth. Whiten it from the outside as much as we can, and then we just do a finisher with all the teeth together. So that's how whitening works. I have done some previous videos on tooth whitening, so if you want to check those out and you want to learn more about tooth whitening, do have a look at those. But in general, what is so incredible about all of this is it's so inexpensive. It's very, very inexpensive for both me and you, the patient, to have this done. And it really, in a matter of a week, you can have a whiter tooth. So if you have that one friend that you just cannot stop staring at their front tooth because it's so dark, do suggest that they listen to this video, or you recommend that they have a dentist, see a dentist who can do this type of internal whitening. And it's called an internal whitening procedure. And typically it has to be on a tooth that's had a root canal. If you would like to hear more about whitening or any sort of cosmetic procedures, I would love to hear from you. Don't forget to subscribe to this channel, because you don't want you to miss an episode. But if you have any other questions, leave me a comment below. Check out the link, and I hope you have a wonderful day. I'll see you next time.